An 85 kilogram piston of a vertical piston cylinder device containing a gas has a cross-section area of 0.05 meters squared and is in static equilibrium. If the volume triples when some heat is transferred to the gas, what is the absolute pressure before and after the heat is added? And what is the mechanical work that results from adding the heat? The atmospheric pressure is 0.94 bar. Remember to pause here to try to solve this problem yourself before watching the solution up next. This is the second example for the Thermodynamics Units and Pressure Basics 11-minute lecture video. The links to that lecture, the other examples on this topic, and the other lectures of the Thermo course are found in the description below. The first question asks for the pressure of the gas inside the cylinder. We know that the piston is in a static equilibrium, meaning that the sum of forces is equal to zero. With a quick free body diagram of the piston, we see that the pressure inside the cylinder is generating an upward force equal to that pressure that we are trying to find, times the area of the piston. Additionally, we have the weight of the piston, mg, going down, as is the downward force caused by the atmospheric pressure going down, also pressure times area. Solving for the initial pressure that we are finding, we get P atmospheric plus mg over A. We substitute the values we have for atmospheric pressure, mass, g, and area, and we notice that the units for the terms on the right are not consistent. If a newton, being a force unit, is mass times acceleration, or in terms of its units, kilograms times meter over second square, we can write the pressure on the right as newtons over meter squared. This is simply pascals. And since 1 bar is 100 kilopascals or 100,000 pascals, we convert this pressure into bar. This means that the pressure inside the cylinder is 1.11 bar. Now, after the heat is added, the volume increases as a result of the gas pushing the piston upward. Does the free body diagram of the piston change after the volume has tripled and the piston is now in equilibrium again? The answer is no. The free body diagram is the same. After the heat has been added and the volume increases, we still have the pressure of the gas inside the cylinder causing the upward force, and that pressure has to be the same because the downward forces are still the same weight, mg, and the same force caused by the atmospheric pressure. As soon as the heat is added, the temperature and pressure do rise, and it is that higher pressure inside the cylinder that causes a net force going up, which accelerates the piston upward until, as the volume increases, the pressure drops and equals its original value until the piston forces reach equilibrium. We'll learn a lot more about this in a future lecture, but for now, just remember that for a piston cylinder device, the pressure is always the same before and after adding or subtracting energy. This means that the pressure after heat is added is the same as it was initially. And finally, what is the mechanical work that comes out of this process? Well, by using the mechanical work definition from physics, which is W equals to F times D, we see that the forces that are being overcome are the weight mg and the atmospheric pressure force P atmospheric times area, and that the distance is whatever the change in height was. If the volume was originally 0.01 meters cubed and the area is 0.05 meters squared, it means that the original height of the gas's volume, and therefore the position of the piston, was 0.2 meters. If the volume tripled, the height itself tripled, since the area remained constant. This means that the change in height for the location of the piston is 0.6 minus 0.2, or 0.4 meters, and therefore the work is 2,213.54 joules. Additionally, and this will become very important for this thermo course real soon, since the pressure the piston is generating is its weight over its area, we can take this work expression and multiply it by the area on the numerator and the denominator to write the work as mg over A plus P atmospheric, which is the piston's pressure plus atmospheric pressure, or just the absolute pressure, times D times A, which is the same as a volume. Since D is the change in height between the initial and the final state, this volume corresponds to the change in volume. Therefore, this work energy is equal to either our first expression or just P delta V. And let's check this. the absolute pressure inside the cylinder, which remained constant before and after adding the heat, is 110,000 pascals, and the change in volume is triple of 0.01 minus 0.01. This results in 2,213.54 joules as well. This expression of work in terms of pressure and volume will be incredibly important for the rest of the course. We'll get to that later, but just remember that this is no random example. For more examples on this unit's topic, as well as the other lectures of the Thermo course and other engineering courses, make sure to check out the links in the description below. Thanks for watching!